Hi Naturals, my name is Dima. Welcome to the channel. Please, if you're new, kindly tap on that red button that says subscribe. Also, give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed watching it. And lastly, please share with your family and friends. On this channel, I share a lot of natural hair growth remedies for thickness, length, and health. On today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you Harmattan hair care tips. Harmattan or winter hair care tips. We are in Nigeria, we call it Harmattan season. Over there in the abroad, I know you guys may call it winter, or if there's any other name for this dry weather, kindly drop it in the comment section below. Harmattan season is here again. Harmattan season is upon us. And that means double trouble, because our hair is made up of kinky curls. Naturally, it's dry, even in wet season. So you need to embrace moisture. You need to make moisture your friend. You need your hair to retain moisture this season. Harmattan poses a serious threat to our hair, and we need to take conscious effort to make sure that our hair stays moisturized and not dry and coarse. I'm going to be sharing with you a few steps you can follow, few tips you can follow to keep your hair moisturized this season, few steps you can follow so that your hair doesn't shed and break off. The first step on my list is moisturize often. Moisturize your hair often. Moisturize, I mean you need to hydrate your hair. You need to apply moisturizing products. You need to apply moisturizers on your hair. And how can you moisturize your hair? You need a liquid. You need a cream, and you need a form of oil, a sealant. I usually call it sealant because that's what locks in the moisture that you put in your hair. You need to hydrate your hair and follow up with a moisturizer, a cream, which is leave-in conditioner. That's what is called on the market. If your hair is high in porosity, I suggest you get a creamier leave-in conditioner. And if your hair is low in porosity, I suggest you get a lighter, lightweight leave-in conditioner. Here is how you can moisturize your hair this season. Whichever method you choose, section your hair into either 4 or 5 or 6 sections. Each of the sections, moisturize it by spraying a liquid, a mist first, just kind of dampening the hair a bit. I don't mean you should drench your hair with water, just dampen the hair a bit, and then apply your leave-in conditioner, and then seal with either hair butter cream or oil. This sealant is what locks in moisture in your hair. That is what keeps the moisture in your hair. It helps the moisture to last longer. Moisturize at least 3 times a week this season. 3 to 4 times a week. If your hair is high in porosity, I advise you moisturize your hair 4 times a week. And if your hair is low in porosity, please moisturize 2 to 3 times a week, because moisture tends to stay in your hair for a while. After moisturizing, make sure to seal in the moisture. Very, very important. I've shared a lot of hair butters, butter cream on this channel, and also hair growth oils. Whichever works for you, please go ahead to use it to seal in this moisture so that it can last longer and make your hair stay soft and healthy. What this season does is to take away this moisture. The environment absorbs this moisture. The moisture in your hair kind of evaporates into the atmosphere, and you need to replenish this moisture back in your hair often this season. This point cannot be overemphasized because you need it. You definitely do need to hydrate and moisturize your hair this dry season. My second tip to keeping your hair moisturized this season is by deep conditioning regularly. You need to deep condition your hair. Get a deep conditioner. If your hair is dry and coarse, or if your hair is hard, it means that it doesn't have enough moisture. Deep conditioners out there on the market, they are not for fancy. They are there for a purpose. You're supposed to buy them and use them in your hair. You need to deep condition your hair after shampooing. What deep conditioners does is to make your hair moisturized, is to keep moisture in your hair and to make your hair manageable enough. So you need the deep conditioner in your hair routine. Every wash day, make sure to use deep conditioning treatment in your hair. Now, there are two types of deep conditioners sold out there on the market. We have the moisturizing deep conditioners and the protein deep conditioners. I recommend you get the moisturizing deep conditioners because they will serve you a purpose this season. They will help you this season. You need moisture in your hair. Get the moisturizing deep conditioners. They will help keep moisture in your hair and help your hair manageable enough this season. My number three tip to keeping your hair moisturized this season is by drinking lots of water. You need to stay hydrated, at least 8 glasses of water a day or even more. You need to moisturize from inside out. The level of your water intake will determine how dry or moisturized your hair is. So you have to drink up. You have to drink lots of water this season. You have to stay hydrated this season. Water is very, very important. If your hair must thrive this Harmattan / winter season, you have to drink up. You have to drink lots of water. Just as the plants need water to thrive, your hair and body and skin needs water to stay hydrated and moisturized. So you have to make water your friend. Drink lots of it, apply lots of it on your hair to keep hydrated. Avoid shampoos that strip your hair of its natural oils. Shampoos like the sulfate shampoos. This season, I suggest you get the moisturizing shampoos. There are shampoos sold on the market that are moisturizing shampoos. Get those ones and use to wash your hair. Those ones that have sleep in them, they are super moisturizing. Those are the ones you should go for this season. Do not get any sulfate shampoo. Do not get any shampoo that will strip your hair of its natural oils. Make sure you get the moisturizing shampoos. And also, after shampooing, make sure to follow up with a deep conditioning treatment to replenish all the moisture lost. And also, before you shampoo, make sure to pre-poo your hair. Pre-poo also helps moisture stay in your hair. You use natural oils to pre-poo, like the olive oil, coconut oil, and all those good oils, penetrating oils. These are the oils that you use to pre-poo. Make sure to pre-poo, and also when get a sulfate-free shampoo or any shampoo that won't strip your hair of its natural oil. So what pre-poo does is to make sure that the shampoo you're using doesn't strip your hair. And even after using your shampoo, make sure to deep condition your hair. My next tip is to avoid touching your hair. Hand in hair syndrome. Avoid over manipulation this period. the best thing that can happen to you is for you to get a protective style. Lock your hair. This is a form of protective style. Make sure your ends are tucked in. Avoid styling your hair all the time. That way, if you're styling your hair all the time, your hair will be drying out. Avoid over manipulation this period. Get your hands off your hair this period so that moisture can last in your hair. My next tip is wear satin bonnet and scarf. Now, if your hair must stay moisturized, you have to wear satin bonnets and scarves to sleep, because the cotton is very, very absorbent. The cotton material used for your pillowcases is very, very absorbent. And even if your hair is moisturized, by the time you get to bed, the cotton material that your pillow and pillowcases are made of will soak up the oils and the moisture in your hair, leaving your hair dry. So you need to cover your hair with satin scarf, satin bonnets. These materials are not absorbent. They help keep your moisture in your hair intact the way you left them, so that by morning your hair stays moisturized. Wear satin scarf and bonnets. No matter how tired you are, make sure to wear them this period. And even if you're at home, you're not going out, you don't need to expose your hair, still wear them. Except you're going out, you can uncover your hair. At this point, I think you should wear more of scarves outdoor and wigs. All these help to maintain and preserve the moisture in your hair. My next tip, wear more of protective styles. You need to wear protective styles this season. That way you keep your hands off your hair. Once you get protective style fixed, your hair is resting for at least 1 to 2 weeks before you loosen them up and get a new one. So get protective styles this period. That way moisture stays in your hair. And when getting protective style, do not neglect your hair in protective styles. Make sure to moisturize and re-moisturize in protective style. Do not neglect your hair in protective styles, so that when you're taking them down, you don't feel bad. Because if your hair is dry while in protective styles, when you're taking them down, they will definitely shed and break the more. You have a lot of hair to pack on the floor and you don't moisturize in protective styles. That brings me to the end of this video. Thank you so much for watching. Here I draw the curtains. Thank you so much for watching this video and watching up to this point. Please, if you watched up to this point, kindly comment hi for me in the comment section below. That will let me know that you got to this point. Please stay safe and stay blessed. And I will see you in my next video by God's grace. Bye, guys.